you walk around Lake LaVerne, you'll notice a new addition on the water. The first of three vegetated floating islands was added to the lake on May 2nd. The islands are designed to improve the water quality by using plants to remove pollutants. But before they could be installed, Austin Stewart and his team from the College of Design first had to build them from scratch. The islands were designed to be 8 feet in diameter with an art component on them to make them more aesthetically pleasing. But the most important part of the island is taking place under the surface, where plant roots are absorbing nutrients like nitrogen and phosphorus.
The roots of the plants are actually in the water column. They're not down in the dirt. So all of 100% of the nutrients are being pulled up by the plants. And then that reduces the risk of algal blooms and other pollution issues.
Faculty and graduate students from multiple disciplines are involved to construct the islands, find the right plants, and study the effects on cleaning the water.
It's actually been a pretty tedious process. We wanted to find plants that are really good at uptaking nutrients, different pollutants like nitrogen and phosphorus.
They also needed plants that were native to Iowa and would look great together. But the ultimate goal of the project is to design islands that will improve water quality and reduce the number of algal blooms.
The algae, when it blooms, it basically deprives the water of oxygen. So fish life, other plants, basically asphyxiate because they don't have the oxygen that they need in order to survive.
The team will be studying the water quality throughout the summer to see how the islands affect the nutrient levels. They're also making their designs and research available online to inform the public and provide resources for people to build their own vegetated floating islands.
We really wanted to just draw attention to both water quality issues, but also the fact that there are these solutions out there and to really make public the solutions.
For more information on the project, visit laverne-islands.com. For Iowa State News Service, I'm Dave Olson.